Says that the Lord will not put any more on you, on your shoulders, than you can bear. He says, when the load gets too heavy to carry, just take it from your shoulder and you put it on his. And then you don't have that weight on your shoulder no more. The Lord will bear it for you. When things are going great, He'll bear that for you. When things are going lousy, He'll pick you up and He'll carry you. I remember a story that I once heard. It was a beautiful story because I'm from California and I know all about the beach. And there was a story of a man, or let's call it a person instead of being so. There was a person walking on the beach. And you know how when you walk on the beach, you leave footsteps on the sand? And he was told that the Lord would carry all of his burdens for him. He would always be right there by his side. But this person, he was on the beach, he was troubled, and he was praying to the Lord God. But he didn't notice, he didn't see that there was footsteps. He figured if God is going to help him out and walk by his side, that there would be two sets of footprints. And he was pretty troubled because he felt that God really wasn't there when he needed him. But then the Lord told him, and I can cry about it because I've been there. The Lord told him, those footsteps you saw on the beach, those were my footsteps. I was carrying you the whole time. So, a lot of people ask me, why am I here in Denmark? Hvorfor har jeg flyttet til Danmark? Jeg flyttede i Danmark i 1990. Jeg var heldig nok til at finde en utrolig dejlig syg kone i San Francisco, hvor jeg blev gift. Efter 20 år, så flyttede vi herover. Men jeg vidste ikke hvorfor. Jeg vidste, at jeg ville gerne tage afsted, men jeg kunne ikke rigtig finde ud af, hvad grunden var. Hvorfor skal jeg flytte til Danmark? Men nu, jeg tror, jeg forstår. Det er fordi, jeg tror, at Danmark har måske en lille brug til hjælp. Til at se mennesker, der bor her i Danmark. Jeg er slet ikke genert til at vise mit glæde og mit kærlighed til Gud. Jeg er ikke genert. Jeg er ikke ramt af det der jantelov. Jeg er ikke bange til at stå op og bare vise min kærlighed og min glæde til Gud. Og jeg er bare så taknemmelig, at Danmark har åbnet deres dør til mig. Jeg kan komme her til jeres land og prøve til at lære jeres sprog, men alligevel til at være sammen med jer og synge min musik med danske mennesker, danske musikere. Ind og ud af dansk kirke, helt over Danmark. Og jeg ved ikke, hvorfor Gud har vægt mig. Fordi jeg er en dårlig, dårlig synder. Jeg synder hele tiden hver dag. Nej, det er rigtigt, men grunden er, at jeg siger det, det fortæller jer, at lige meget, at hvor dårlig en person du er, eller du ikke er, men Gud kan bruge alle mennesker. Han kan tilgive alt. Det næste nummer, den hedder How Much We Can Bear. Det er en lidt anderledes nummer, fordi det er den eneste nummer, hvor vi skal præsentere en rapper. Vi skal være lidt rap på den her sang. Men før vi kommer i gang med den her sang, jeg vil gerne præsentere vores musiker, fordi I har ikke mødt dem nu. På trommer har vi Casey. Så har vi på bass, vi har Peter. Og i løbet af det hele aften, du har nemlig hørt på bass, Frank Anker. Hvor er det med Frank? Thomas. Og herovre til min venstre side har vi... Det er så mange piger i Danmark, jeg kan ikke forstå det, men så har vi Peter og Peter på keyboards og orgel. Og det har jeg lært her i Danmark, at man skal altid præsentere lydmænd og lysmænd, så det er der. Og nu skal jeg præsentere en helt ny stil af gospel. Det er helt til blive i Danmark. Det er en blanding af det gamle dage. Det er en blanding af rock and roll. Det er en blanding af alt. Men nu skal jeg præsentere den første rapper i Danmark til gospel music. Slip! Give it up! Yeah.
just like me. Maybe to a true MC, what up, dude, that's me. Slim with a tilted friend, but who I be. Never been afraid to speak my mind. See what's with, seek, and then you'll find. Just blowing up steam with a rap vocal bit. Never been kicked to New York City, what? Preacher man, son, kid with a mission. Leader of the whole expedition, word is born. Coming through, get the attention on the call now. I love rock and roll. Keep my head straight just to reach my goal. On the real though, I know you learned your lesson. Keep your head up and let the Lord keep blessing.
Carrie's gonna come to us and says, oh Lord, how majestic is thy name in all the earth. Come on, let's give Brother Carrie a hand. I can't complain. When you think that you're having problems,
you will encounter someone that will make your problems seem like a bump on a log. So I know that you know that I'm right. And because God has blessed us to be who we are, what we are, to have the things that we have, I think he's worthy of some praise. You know, we sometimes take the small things for granted. You know, we always talk about the large things. Oh, God gave me a home. He gave me a car. But what about God gave you life? But isn't it good to know that there is somebody who do have that kind of power? So, you know how easy it is to take somebody for granted. It happens. You know I'm right. It happens. I've done it. You don't mean to, but it happens. But tonight, let's not take God for granted. Tonight, I may not see you all again, but tonight, join with me. Let's not take God for granted and all that he's done and all that he's going to do. Let's not take it for granted. Let's just have a good time and exalt him. Lift him up, praise him, worship him, magnify him, glorify him. Everybody want to be appreciated. I want to be appreciated. Don't you think God want to be appreciated? If he's done all of this for you, don't you think he want to hear you say thank you? So before I start this song, I want you to think about something. If you ask somebody to lend you a helping hand, let's use money, for instance. You may not be able to pay your mortgage, your car payment. You don't know where your next meal is coming from. And you reach out to your brother or your sister and say, I need help. I need help. And somehow they come and put the money in your hand. Are you gonna be quiet and not say thank you? Are you going to tell them, well, I was appreciative. I didn't tell you because I thought you knew. No, I didn't know. The only way I know is if you tell me. If I helped you out of a situation that you didn't see a way out, then yes, I do want to know that you appreciate it. Tell me, how do you think God feels? sure. If God, like I know he is watching, I'm sure with all of that. I know if y'all did that for me, I would sure be sitting with my chest out. So I'm sure he's pleased. And I know that he's pleased when people begin to give him praise. Because he's worthy to be praised. We're gonna move on, and this song is called Beloved. And it's a very special song to me because this song is taken from the book of John. Three books from Revelations. And what it's saying, actually, God is telling me that I'm special. And do you know how good it feels to know that someone finds you to be very special? Ladies, I'm sure you appreciate your husbands. Husbands, I'm sure you appreciate your wife. And I'm sure every now and then, you have to express how you feel about them. I love my wife, and I know that she loved me, but I want to be told that she loves me. I don't want to read nobody's minds. No. I want to know that you love me. Everybody need to feel love. It hurts if you know that you're not loved. You want to feel appreciated. And this song lets me know that God loves me. So if no one ever, ever tell me that they love me, I don't care. Because I know that God loves me. You know, we have a lot of people who are hooked on drugs and don't want to tell nobody because they're afraid that they won't love them anymore. We have family members who are out on the streets who want to come back home, but they're afraid because they don't feel like they're loved. We need to express love. God is love. And because of his love, he sent his only begotten Son to die for us. That's the greatest love of all. So we need in Copenhagen to exercise love. Men, you're not so macho that you can't tell somebody that you love them. It's not a sign of weakness. I'm sure you wanted to know that you were loved. So it's not a sign of weakness. It's actually expressing love. That's showing that you are a man. You are a man because you don't care who knows it. That's being a man. I love you, wife. I love you, daughter. I love you, son. I love you, God. If we would show love just a little more, some of these problems that we're experiencing, I'm sure, would decrease. It's no harm in giving someone a hug. A bullet will kill you. A hug won't. Makes sense to me. I never seen a serial killer go with you. I'm gonna kill you. I've never seen it. So it's not gonna hurt. Try it. You might like it. How will you know unless you try? So this song is expressing love. It's saying that God loves us. And we are the sons of God.
We share, we change.
shall be holy, for we shall see him, and we shall be like he is.
Hallelujah.
You know, every year we come and we do these workshops, and we never, never ask if anybody would like to change their life.
Hallelujah.
If there's anybody that would like to say to God, God, I want to try this Christianity. God, I want to see what you're like, and from a real standpoint. Not just going to church every Sunday, just sitting there and just doing the ritual, but to understand what it means to have a personal relationship with God. Not religion, but a spiritual relationship with God. We're in an unusual time. We've lived through decades. We've lived through scores. Some of us have lived close to centuries, but we never lived to the end of a millennium. And many of us are a little confused because we don't understand what's going on. We have many questions that are unanswered. Who is God? Who is he to me? What does he mean to me? Who am I in God? We didn't come just to sing to entertain you. We did not come to entertain you. We've come to quicken your spirits. We've come to quicken your spirits to have a greater understanding of who God is and who he wants to be in your life. In your life. There might be someone here who enjoys gospel music, and you come every year and you enjoy it and you clap your hand, but you leave and there is some song in your spirit that you can't stop singing. We're going to open what we call in America the doors of the church. And if there is anyone here, anyone who would like to come up and say, I want to be saved. You might just want to recommit your life to Christ. You just might want to say, Lord, I want to better understand you. Lord, I want a better knowledge of you. There are pastors here from the city. There's a Pentecostal pastor. There's a Methodist pastor. There's a Lutheran pastor from every, just about every denomination. And if you would like to make this change in your life, I want to sing this little song for you. It says, we offer Christ to you, oh my brother. We offer Christ to you, oh my sister. He will give you brand new life, life abundantly. So
Jeg vil bede vores også fem dirigenterinstruktører og kommersindelser op her på en række. Vi skal ligesom se dem i samme flok. Nu de hopper og danser rundt, som knap nok fylder den over hjem. Could you please come here and stand, so we could see all of you? Der er noget, jeg har tænkt på hele aften. Det bliver Katrine Kruse frem også. Der er noget, jeg har tænkt på hele aften, det er, de her 630 mennesker, de har kun haft 3 dage til at øve alt det, som vi lyttede til i aften. Er det ikke imponerende? Jeg synes, at mennesker herinde i cirkusbygningen i aften ikke står og råber, at vi synes, I er gode, men vi synes, I er gode. Selvfølgelig så er det sådan, at når nogen bliver gode, så er det også, at der er nogen, der har været til at undervise og lære. Og det har vores 5 prægtige venner, specielt 4 prægtige venner her, Katarina, har været med til at dirigere Comedic Music Gospel Choir. Vi vil gerne lige give jer en lille opmærksomhed omkring det. Værsgo. Vi har som sagt Katrine Brunstrøm, som er dirigent og leder for Copenhagen Community Gospel Choir, der har været på først her. Og så er det Carrie Smith, som har været en prægtig så har det været Dina Steinvik, som kommer igen forhåbentlig også næste år, eller hvad siger det, Peter? Skal vi se det her næste? Sidste her med Albert Campos. Thank you very much, Albert. And then we have Patrick Henderson. And I would just say to you, Patrick, I think that you have been a kind of a spark to a flame that will make tomorrow much more warmer for us. Please pray for us that it may grow and grow bigger, this flame. Thank you very much, and God bless you. Så er det en meget udsøgt fornøjelse at få lov til at være jeres vært i aften. Vi er nået til det tidspunkt, hvor vi skal til at sige tusind tak for i aften her fra cirkusbygningen i København. Det har været en udsøgt fornøjelse. Se nu kommer rigtig godt hjem.
This is the last song of the evening, but now I gotta ask y'all, have you ever seen anything so beautiful? Oh. Now, I don't know if they're gonna let me on the plane with this in the morning, but if y'all read in the paper that this black guy got a little rude because they wouldn't let him take his flowers off, you know it's me. They are so beautiful.
It's against the law. You have to leave those flowers with me.
No. The last song, praise you the Lord. Lift up your hand.
I'm gonna go.
skal bare afslutte af med at sige, at jeres lille lortsnak, man får ikke lyst til at være med til at synge gospel, ikke sandt? Nu kan jeg ikke se, nu kan jeg godt også høre mange, der kan ikke synge gospel der, men der er sådan en rimelig sort ud, det kan jeg se. Men, nu skal I se. De, som har nået at få Nejlesen program på vej herinde forbi fra, der er på side 6, der står der, at synge gospel i København. Hvis det er der, så hvis du kunne tænke dig at være med til at synge gospel i København, så er du velkommen til at kigge her på side 6, og så er der en række numre. Hvis du stadigvæk er i tvivl, så vil jeg godt bede lige om, at vi ser Peter Steinvik igen, fordi så er han manden, som kan lede dig på rette vej til det gospelkor, som du eventuelt kunne være med og synge i. Tak for det. Og hvis du vil læse mere om det gospelkor i København, som sagt, så kan du også læse på internettet, www.gospel.dk. Tak for i aften. Kom rigtig godt hjem, og have en god uge.